Hello everyone, this is the fourth video of Python for Beginners course, and in this video I'll be teaching you how to use various data types in Python. Basically there are two data types, there are strings and numbers, and if we consider numbers there are some other data types like float, integers, base 16 numbers, base 8 numbers and binary and so on. So let's see how these various data types work. First, open your Python shell. Now, let's say A equals inside this quotation marks. I say apple, A-P-P-L-E, is a name. And now let's say we need to know what is the data type of this variable. To know what data type is this, we have to type then the variable name inside this bracket. Then it will say what type of data is this. And now let's say b equals 10, which is an integer. And if we type b, it says us as we expect, it's an integer. Now let's say something like this, c equals 0x a. And if we go to that and if we try to get the value of c back, it does not give what we expect. It is not the same thing that we entered before. That's because this value here is a base 16 value, and when we type 0x, the Python understand now we are going to enter base 16 value, and after entering that, Python automatically convert it to base 10. So other words, it is a decimal number and it converts into integers. If we try to see the type of this integer, so the variable type c, it is an integer. Likewise, let's say d equals 0 0 0, let's say b. So there is no b in octal numbers. So let's say 0 0 7 1, and the value of that octal number is 57. And let's give this value to d. D equals 0 0 71. And if we try to get the type of this value d, it is an integer. That's because Python automatically converts these hexadecimal and octal numbers into decimal numbers, and then the type of decimal numbers is usually integer. And now let's see how to add float numbers. Let's say e equals 1.234, and if we try to get the type of this variable e, it is a float. Now let's see how to convert these data types one by one. First, let's say we have a equal 10, which is in integer format, and now let's say we want to convert it to a string. To do that, what we do is we give a new variable name called b. And after that, we are giving this str and the variable name, which is a. And after that, if we try to say the type of that b variable, it is giving us a string. Sometimes when we get in user input, users give them as strings, and we have to convert them into integers, float values, octal values and other values. So this is how to convert these values. Let's say we get some kind of string value for C variable like this 100, no 1000 as a string. But for our calculations, we have to convert this into an integer. So otherwise, this string won't. We can't do the calculations with this string. To do that, what we do is we give another variable name called d, and the value of that d is integer value of the c, which is 1000. And if we try to get the type of that value d, it gives us as integer. Just like that, we can convert these data types in between. And there are some restrictions. If we try to convert this, let's say we have a string like this a, b, c, d, and if we try to convert this string into an integer, it should give us error because there is no integer value for this kind of strings. It should be a number. This is a value error because this value cannot be converted into integers. That because these are not numbers. And there is another data type which computers use to store values in the memory. It is called byte. Bytes look like this. Let's say d equals byte value of 100. Sorry, it's bytes, not byte. And if we get the output of d, it is like this. This is how the computer store data in the memory. And sometimes when we work with files, we have to convert between these byte data and other things. Sometimes bytes into strings, sometimes bytes into numbers, like that. So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching.